Good morning, people watching Miss 65. Lisa Boyce here. I am going to give you the gospel. It's in 1 Corinthians 15, 1 through 4, that Christ spilled his blood for our sins, past, present, and future, was buried, and rose again on the third day, according to Scripture. We are saved by grace through faith in Christ alone. We will never lose our salvation once you truly, truly believe in the Lord and accept his death, burial, and resurrection, his finished work at the cross. We are saved and sealed until the day of redemption. It's a gift, not of ourselves, lest any man should boast. Just remember that. If we truly believe in what he did for us, that he spilled his blood and that he rose on the third day, we are saved and sealed, never ever losing our salvation. I know that's a hot topic lately, but it's true. And there's verses that have that in there. But for the sake of time, I'm going to give you this article that is very important. Now, this is off of the Star, and I had to verify because a lot of times the Star, I don't really trust them that much. But I looked into it, and this is true. China and Russia have weaponized space with killer energy weapon satellites. So this is true. This came out, when did this come out? Today. This morning. It says that China and Russia have successfully weaponized space by developing killer satellites with directed energy weapons. United States Secretary of Defense Mark Esper has claimed. Esper issued the stark warning at the Air Force Association Virtual Air, Space, and Cyber Conference on Wednesday, which was yesterday, saying that he claimed that the U.S.'s longstanding adversaries seek to erode our longstanding dominance in air power in space. Moscow and Beijing have turned a once peaceful arena into a war-fighting domain, he said. They have weaponized space using killer satellites, directed energy weapons, and more in effort to exploit our systems and chip away at our military advantage. I have been saying this a couple of months ago. Furthermore, our competitors and adversaries exploit cyberspace to undermine our security without confronting our conventional strains. They do this all in an increasingly gray zone of engagement that keeps us in a perpetual state of competition. In an effort to combat these threats and maintain America's military edge, Esper said the Air Force is advancing critical technologies, but I'm thinking it might be a little bit too late. Look, folks, I'm going to link this article in the description box. We're at the end. We're not in the last days. We're not in the last days. We're in the last seconds. And whatever's going on is about to come to a head. It's about to come to a head. I feel in my heart of hearts that we are about to take off anytime. With all this that's happening, I implore you to get saved. It is the most important thing that you can do right now is to get saved. I will be back later with more. But in the meantime, have a nice morning.